This is Luke Paulson, the Catholic Conservative, and welcome to the News of the Week for
July 16th, 2022.
And if you enjoy these videos, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more.
PBS's abominable finding. PBS is funded by tax dollars. Naturally, there's going to be some bias from deep within the swamp. That is the pattern that we see everywhere. Just like we see with NPR. I will get back to them in a few minutes. PBS has already found that there is no gay gene, and so there is no genetic basis for sodomy. This means that it is a sinful choice of someone who rejects God's authority as well as his laws. Now PBS has come out with another major finding. First, the background. They showed a group of people several images of disgusting things, like flies buzzing around rotting meat, and measured their reactions. The scientist then gave the people a political alignment test, and found that the levels of disgust were much lower in liberals than in conservatives. With 95% accuracy, the testers could predict your political alignment with how easily you are disgusted at abominable things. That makes sense if you ask me. Consider that liberals are perfectly fine with all kinds of moral debauchery, such as sodomy, satanic temples and statues, men pretending to be women and competing unfairly with them, children dancing at gay bars for dollar bills, not to mention drag queen story hour. All of these things should be making liberals sick, but they must have trained themselves to not vomit when they see abhorrent things. Absentee ballot boxes in court. Wisconsin has made a major step towards securing our elections. In response to an outcry over how absentee ballot boxes are insecure, said boxes are now illegal in Wisconsin. Are they illegal in your state? You had better find out. These ballot boxes were rampant during this last election because of the pandemic. Now ballots have to be physically handed to the appropriate clerk with a very clear chain of custody. The court did not rule on whether or not the ballot could be delivered by a third party or if it had to be delivered by the person in question. Either way, this should not affect any election at all, since what we had in 2020 was the most secure election ever and there was nothing underhanded whatsoever. I mean, it is not as if anyone has been arrested for delivering countless ballots to a single box. Oh wait, what's this? First mule arrested. Georgia Guidestones exploded. Some unknown individual set up an explosion at the Georgia Guidestones, although other people are claiming that it was a bolt of lightning. Either way, according to the fake news, these stones are not only a clock and a calendar, but also show how to rebuild humanity after an apocalypse. There was nothing even remotely related to that on these stones. The first rule listed is to, quote, maintain humanity under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature, close quotes. That is roughly a 95% reduction of the planet's present population. That has absolutely nothing to do with rebuilding the planet, but it is an admission of an extinction level event. The third rule is to, quote, unite humanity with a living new language. We saw at the Tower of Babel how that is a very poor idea, as it leads to defying the command of God. Different languages forced us to fulfill the will of God. The tenth rule is to, quote, be not a cancer on the earth, leave room for nature, close quotes. We see this from climate alarmists that build houses on the coast and fly in private jets every day.
Human beings are a disease, a a cancer of this planet. You are a plague. And we are the cure.
Humanity's actions are supposedly killing the planet. Harkening back to the first rule, they have stopped having kids to not damage the Earth any further. The problem is that the population bomb has never gone off. There is no reason to snap half of the population out of existence because we have not yet fully populated the Earth. Humanity finds ways to improve and live in inhospitable environments and make goods cheaper than ever before. That is thanks to capitalism, not government. I am happy that this monument to the Democratic Party is torn down. Let us move on to the rest of their legacy. No right to privacy. When Roe v. Wade was first ruled on by white men, the argument used was that a woman had a constitutional right to privacy. I have read that document once or twice, and I have yet to find a single mention of the word privacy or any variation thereof that could give that impression. In response to a leaked SCOTUS decision, Democrats started protesting outside of justices' houses in an attempt to get them to change their minds. This, in itself, is illegal, but what about the right to privacy? However, the protesters did not stop there. They decided that Kavanaugh and his wife were peacefully eating in a restaurant, and so they had to be accosted. It was never about privacy. It was all about an excuse to kill as many children in the womb as possible. Oh, did I mention that the same groups are putting a bounty on Kavanaugh? They will pay the restaurant for information relating to a protest opportunity. Chicago shooter revelations. The majority of these mass shooters are without a father. There are a handful of exceptions, but it is the rule. The shooter in Chicago is notably an exception, but it might have been better if he was not in the picture at all. Aside from the countless warning signs, the killer's father decided to buy his son a gun. In Illinois, he would need a parent to sign on to the purchase, and like co-signing a loan, he would be liable if his son committed an act of violence with said weapon. I originally predicted that the kid would be unable to purchase a gun legally, and thus more gun laws would do nothing. It seems that I was at least partly right. Speaking of more gun control laws, Safer Community Act. The Safer Community Act follows a trend of big government in naming legislation based on the opposite of what it does. This does nothing whatsoever to make any community safer. It expands red flag laws to someone whom you may or may not still be in a relationship with. If we have learned one thing from the trial between Johnny Depp and Amber Heard, women can be abusive too. As soon as Kavanaugh was nominated, Christine Blasey Ford decided that she would lie before Congress about an event that never occurred. As soon as Elon Musk announced his purchase of Twitter, an old Me Too case came back up. Under the Safer Community Act, all three of these men could have had their right to bear arms taken away. After all, this law allows the right to be taken away based on hearsay only. Not that Democrats mind when that is brought before the January 6th committee. Elon Musk goes back and forth. Elon Musk, to the average person, myself included, seems to be flip-flopping on his Twitter acquisition. However, every step of the way, Musk has been playing them like a fiddle. Twitter's board forced them to sell because it was the most financially viable for the company and for their stockholders. The large concentration of bots started being revealed, including the revelation that half of Brandon's followers are bots. Now Twitter is trying to force Musk to uncancel in court. Then they will be forced to prove their bot problem in court, where the representatives can be charged with perjury. President Trump and Elon Musk are playing 4D chess. Ending NPR. I question why we need a taxpayer-funded media outlet in the first place. Every year, they read the Declaration of Independence to celebrate the freedoms that it helped to ensure. This year, the network decided that they would argue about the meaning of the word equality. This is the same political alignment that judges people based on the color of their skin rather than the content of their character. The purpose of the media is to hold those in positions of authority accountable. We do not need a taxpayer-funded media outlet. We have the New York Times that targeted Project Veritas and waited until after the election to verify Hunter Biden's laptop for that. This is just another source of fake news. The only difference is that you and I are paying for it. Is it any wonder that there is a new push to defund NPR? Selling off our oil. Russia had every reason to support Hillary Clinton to sit in the Oval Office. Not only did she give them, and every country that wanted it, favors through her connections at the State Department, she sold American uranium and lined her own pocket. Now that Brandon has tapped the emergency petroleum reserves, gas has gone down from an arm and a leg to just an arm. However, like Clinton before him, Brandon is not satisfied with putting America first. He decided to ship our oil to other countries like India and China. The company in China has ties to Hunter Biden, and this will thus line Brandon's pocket. Is it any wonder why so many Americans love the idea of putting America first? You can see loved ones. Democrat governors and mayors across the country decided that the single best thing to do to fight the pandemic was to isolate people with the virus from everyone that loved them. The only problem is that humans are social creatures, and we need human interaction. There is anecdotal evidence to suggest that people that were cut off from all human interaction died as a result of the depression. That really is not too far-fetched. We see people that retire very quickly wither away every day. Governor DeSantis does not want that to happen to anyone ever again. He signed a bill forbidding hospitals from keeping you from seeing your loved ones. Not only can you visit them without proof of vaccination, you can talk to them and hug them as much as they want. The only people who would oppose this are those that are still wearing masks that are as effective as a chain link fence at stopping mosquitoes, sending illegals to the border. What do you do if illegals are coming into your country by the caravan, with both human traffickers and drug dealers in tow? A. Do absolutely nothing so that you cannot be called racist. B. Ship them all over the country in an attempt to facilitate your replacement theory. Or C. Empower law enforcement to take them back to the border. Naturally, I would choose option C. That is exactly what Governor Abbott is doing. Since the federal government will not protect the border, he will. He has empowered law enforcement to take illegals back to the border. He was successful with busing them to DC. Let us see what will happen. Brandon supersedes SCOTUS. I have said it before, and I will say it again. The last time that a Democrat president decided that he did not have to follow a Supreme Court ruling, we had a mass genocide. Brandon and the rest of the Democrats have decided that the latest Supreme Court ruling overturning Roe v. Wade does not apply to them. He has decreed that if the woman's life is in danger, she has every right to an abortion. Officially, doctors may be wary about performing the procedure so that they are not arrested. However, the number of instances in which the mother's life would be in danger are so insignificantly small that they basically do not exist. Even so, it is the job of parents to protect their child above all else. Brandon has essentially said,
John Marshall has made his decision, now let him enforce it.
Playing during a tragedy. What do you do if there is an active shooter in the school and you are a police officer that is sent in to stop him? If you are a member of the Uvalde Police Department, you need to stand around and play on your phone. You might also check layout plans without moving from where you are. You might even talk with your fellow officers. All the while, you would be keeping parents from going in to rescue their children. After all, they would be interfering in an active crime scene. It takes an off-duty Border Patrol agent with a borrowed gun to take down the shooter. The police chief, or captain, gave a stand-down order. I propose so that they could justify civilian disarmament. All of those children killed to make a political point. How sickening. Maybe I'm just blowing smoke. Maybe I'm completely off my rocker, but that is just my opinion. And if you enjoyed this content, do not forget to like, comment, and most importantly, subscribe for more. And also don't forget to follow me on social media.